Hello students, in this video we are discussing a gate numerical. Consider a discrete time channel y equal to x plus z, where the additive noise z is a signal dependent. In particular, given the transmitted symbol x belongs to minus a or plus a at any instant, the noise symbol z is chosen independently from a Gaussian distribution with the mean is some beta x and unit variance. Assume the threshold detector with a zero threshold at the receiver. When beta equal to zero, the BER is found to be q of a equal to 1 into 10 power minus 8. And a given Q function value, Q of V equal to 1 over root 2 pi integral V to infinity e power minus e square by 2 du. And if V value greater than 1, you can approximate Q of V approximately e power minus V square by 2. When beta is minus 0.3, the BER is closest to 2. That is the question. If you observe there, I can say, expected value of the received one, y is nothing but x plus y, so x plus z, so I can write x plus separately z also I can write. And here what is saying that when beta is 0, its mean is beta x. If beta is 0, then this mean value will also becoming as 0, then the remaining is expected value of x. Let's take plus a symbol they are transmitting, so a. And here they told that when this beta is 0, BER is found to be q of a equal to 1 into 10 power minus 8. For b value greater than 1, you can approximate this value as e power minus v square by 2, but in place of v, we have a is there. So, e power minus a square by 2. Then, you can equate and if you calculate, you will get a value 6. Now, follow. When beta is minus 0.3, let's see. Expected value of y equal to expected value of x plus expected value of z. Expected value of x is just now we got a. And expected value of z means mean. And see here, are you getting my point or not? Here if you are observing, minus beta value minus 0.3. Are you getting my point? And what is x means the variable a? What is that a value? We got 6. Are you getting my point? So, what is this value? Minus 1.8. And a value 6 now. So, this value 6 minus 1.8. Then it will be 4.2 is the mean. Then substitute. Are you getting my point or not? Then here, this mean is we got 4.2. So calculate the bit error rate. So I can say bit error rate equal to Q of A, of course here the mean, which is 4.2, is approximately, because this value greater than 1, you can write e power minus. Are you getting my point or not? So, a square by 2, and if you calculate here the value of a, approximately it is coming as 0.001. So, we can say 0.00 another one. Yeah. If you observe this one, you can approximate as 10 power minus 4. So, I can say option C. A simple model, and here the given mean is beta x. By taking beta value 0 and he given, by taking beta value minus 0.3, we are calculating. And here if you equate the a value will come, that we will substitute, we will get the mean, and for that we will calculate. Got my point? Consider a communication scheme where binary values signal satisfies probability of x equal to 1 is 0.75, probability of x equal to minus 1 is 0.25. The received signal y equal to x plus z, where Z is a Gaussian random variable with a zero mean variance sigma square. The received signal is fed to a threshold detector. The output of a threshold detector x cap of t is x cap equal to plus 1 when received value y is greater than tau, minus 1 for less than or equal to tau. To achieve minimum probability of error, the threshold tau should be strictly positive or 0 or strictly negative, strictly positive comma 0 or strictly negative depending upon the sigma square value. For a binary receiver, what is the formula we have directly shortcut? The formula for threshold is nothing but students, sigma square by x1 minus x2 into ln of p of x2 by p of x1 plus x1 square minus x2 square by 2 sigma square. This is the threshold formula for binary channel. Here, what is the symbol x1 is 1, another one is minus 1. So, sigma square by 1 minus of minus 1, 2 into ln of p of x2. What is the x2 value probably given? 0.25. Because this I treated as x2. Divided by 0.75 plus 1 square minus of minus 1 square is 1. 1 minus 1 0. So, this value is 0. Then it is nothing but sigma square by 2 into, I can write ln of 25 by 75, 1 by 2. So, this value will be definitely negative. If this value is negative, then definitely VTH value is negative. So, I can say that strictly it is negative. Regarding the derivation, you can follow our video lectures. What is it? Shortcut for threshold for a binary chart. Clear? Let x be a 0 mean unit variance Gaussian random variable. What is a Gaussian random variable? We know that Gaussian random variable PDF is f of x equal to 1 divided by 2 pi into root. Root 2 pi into sigma square. Sigma square is variance. Variance is 1. E power minus x minus a value is mean value 0. So x square by 2 sigma square value 1, so 2. And we need to calculate the expected value of mod x is integral minus infinite to plus infinite mod x into its PDF. That is 1 over root 2 pi into e power minus x square by 2 dx. Mod x values are minus x for negative values, plus x for positive values. So, it can be written as integral minus infinite to 0 minus x into 1 over root 2 pi into e power minus x square by 2 dx plus 0 to infinity x into 1 over root 2 pi into e power minus x square by 2 dx. Are you getting the point or not? Now, if you replace x with any dummy variable minus y or minus x, you can also write this as similar to that. Because to avoid the negative signs, then minus dx will come, limits we can change it. So, it is 2 times the integral 0 to infinity x into or x divided by root 2 pi e power minus x square by 2 dx. How to solve this integral is, you can take x by root 2 is some t. Are you getting my point or not? Then, yeah, x by any change of variables, x by root 2 equal to some dummy variable t, then it will be 2 by root pi into x by root 2 is t, so integral 0 to infinity t into e power minus this value, obviously t square, into dx value. What is the dx value? Root 2 into dt. Root 2 comes outside. Solve this integral general method, then it will be, if we solve in this value, you will get 0.8. declare a binary random variable x takes the value of 1 with probability 1 by 2. Then obviously 0 probability 2 by 2. The x is input to the cascade of two independent identical binary symmetric channels, each with crossover probability 1 by 2. The output of BSCs are random variable y1 and y2 as shown in figure. The value of h of y1 plus h of y2 is, and this is the system equivalent. Are you getting my point? So, and let me first write the BSC channel. How the BSC channel? B means binary. So, it is having only two inputs, 0 and 1. You can also name some x0 and x1 also for easy of understanding. And it is having two outputs, also 0 and 1. You can also call y0 and y1. This y1 different. So, if you want, you can make some dashes. And what is the probability of x1? Probability of x1 that is becoming 1 is given 1 by 3. Obviously, this is 2 by 3. And he told crossover probability. How much is given? 1 by 2. If this is 1 by 2, obviously, this is also 1 by 2. Then this is crossover 1 by 2 means this is also 1 by 2. So this is also 1 by 2. Now he is asking, calculate y1 and y2 and bring their entropy values. Can I say that y1 matrix is nothing but input matrix? What is the input matrix? 1 probability, 0 probability 2 by 3, 1 probability 1 by 3 into channel matrix. What is the channel? Y0 by, that is y0 dash by x0, 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Multiply 2 by 3 into 1 by 2, 2 by 6 plus 1 by 6, 3 by 6, so 1 by 2. Next, 2 by 3 into 1 by 2, 2 by 6 plus 1 by 6, so another 1 by 2. Similar manner, calculate y2 also. For y2, what is the input? Y1. So, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Channel matrix same. Why channel matrix same? Because same BSC channel is he told. So, what is that? 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. Still 1 by 2. That is also 1 by 2. And he is asking entropy. Calculate, there are two probabilities are there. Two symbols are there. Both are having equal. Equal means, can I say what is the entropy? Simple log 2 base 2. Because two symbols of equal probability. What is the log 2 value? 1. Because base is 2. Here also same. H of y1 equal to, sorry, y2 equal to also 1. So 1 plus 1, answer is 2. Let x1, x2, x3 be independent and identically distributed random variables with the uniform distribution 0 to 1. The probability P of x1 plus x2 less than or equal to x3 is dash. Now if you observe there, I can say that probability of x1 plus x2 minus x3 less than or equal to 0. Now I can call the whole is one random variable z. Then I can say this is the probability of z less than or equal to 0. Where here, what is the random variable z? Is nothing but x1 plus x2 minus x3. Let me write the random variable in capital letters. Now, we need to calculate the PDF of z. Once if we calculate the PDF of z, what is the probability? Simply integrate in that region. So, minus infinite to 0. F of z, dz. Have you got my point or not? So, let's bring the PDF of z. If this is the combination, then what is the PDF of z? If it is x plus y, then f of x1 convolution with f of x2 minus is there. So, what we have to do, I told convolution with f of minus x3. I give it in the previous problems. If the combination equal to x plus y, then f of z is f of x convolution with f of y. if it is if it is combination minus is a f of minus y, I told. And here x1, x2, x3 are independent and uniformly distributed in the region of 0 to 1. So what is the PDF of x1? PDF of x1 is nothing but it is existing from 0 to 1 he given. And what is the PDF of x2? It is also uniformly distributed, existing from 0 to 1. And what is x3? It is also uniformly distributed from 0 to 1. First of all, what I will do is, I will calculate the convolution between these two. Later I will apply this. Then, what is the convolution of two rectangular pulses of equal width? Is nothing but a triangular pulse. Lower limit equal to sum of the two lower, upper limit is equal to sum of the two upper limits. In between, draw the triangular pulse. And what is this value? Is nothing but we have to calculate first slope. Slope is product of the amplitudes. 1 into 1, 1. So slope is 1. Slope is 1 means obvious middle value 1. 1 unit of time, it can rise up to 1. So up to here is done. Simple thing, but here the actual thing is there. Convolution with f of minus x3. How to calculate minus x3? Multiply all these values by negative sign. 0 with 0, 1 with negative, minus 1. So we have to convolute the both. And if you observe there, here it's not a x or x versus, because it is a random variable, x and x. Now if you are observing here, convolution of these two. And this is having ramp type of variation, this is having step type of variation. So try to represent the signal by using ramp. How to represent the ramp? Wherever there is a slope changes, write the ramp. Slope changes. What is the slope before 0? 0. 0 to 1, 1. 1 to 2, minus 1. After 2, 0. Then write the ramp. So how to write? R of x starting from 0. Next slope change at 1. What is the change? Final minus initial. Minus 1, minus 1. So minus 2 into R of x minus 2. Next slope change at 2. Final minus initial. Right side minus left side. So what is the change? 0 minus or minus 1 plus 1. So R of x, this is at 1, sorry. This is at 1, this is at 2. Convolution with, represent this by using the step signals. Wherever there is amplitude change, write the step. Amplitude change at minus 1. So U of x plus 1. Next amplitude change at 0. So U of x. Same amplitude. Now convolute about convolution of ramp with step is nothing but a parabola, or convolution of any signal with step is nothing but integral of that signal. Integral of ramp also parabola. So if you do, what you will get? R of x convolution with u, parabola. So P you can call P of x plus 1, but parabola is 1 by 2. Are you getting my point? Parabola expression is t square into u of t by 2. So I represent the parabola p rather than writing that. I can also write in terms of step signal how t square into u of t. T square means here x plus 1 whole square into u of x. Parabola expression t square into u of t by 2. Next, minus into plus minus 2. Parabola means 1 by 2 into x minus 1, x plus 1. So x. So x square into u of x. Minus into minus plus. Anyhow, 1 by 2 will come. This will be gone. So x minus 1, x. So x minus 1 whole square into u of x plus and so on. The terms will come. I didn't already, for this one also you can convolve, but I am not interested to write. Why? Because where to where you have to integrate from minus infinity, but a function existing only from minus 1 to 0. Minus 1 to 0 means these are all starting from 0 onwards. Minus 1, it is starting at minus 1. So this is u of r of x. So x plus 1, this is x plus 1. Yeah. This is existing from minus 1 to 0. Remaining all are starting from 0. But we need only up to 0. And what is that value? Convert in terms of random variable z. So I can say z plus 1 whole square into dz. Then if you are solving this, 1 by 2 constant outside, integral minus 1 to 0, a plus b whole square formula. So a square, 1 by 2 is common for all, plus minus 1 to 0, b square, b is nothing but 2ab, so 2z dz plus integral minus 1 to 0, are you getting that? Plus b square, b is 1, so 1 square 1, so dz. Are you getting my point or not? So, this is nothing but 1 by 2 is there. Z square integration, z cube by 3, limits are from minus 1 to 0, plus 2 constant outside, z square by 2, 2 to gone, so remaining is z square, minus 1 to 0, dz is z, limits are from minus 1 to 0. Then this is nothing but 1 by 2 into upper limit is 0, leave it, minus lower limit. Minus z cube is minus minus 1 because minus 1 whole cube is minus 1 will come. So plus 1 by 3. Substitute upper limit 0, lower limit minus 1. Minus 1 square is plus 1, already minus is there, so minus 1. Upper limit 0, lower limit minus of this, minus minus plus. Minus 1 plus 1 gone, 1 by 2 into 1 by 1 by 2 into 1 by 3, so 1 by 6 is the answer. Why I am not written the rest of things are because integration is only from minus infinity, but it is starting from minus 1 to 0 only. So that's why I am not written. Clear? Simple problem only, but you need to get the convolution correct. A real band limited random process x of t has two side PSD, Sx of f equal to 10 power minus 6, 3000 minus mod f, where for mod f is less than or equal to 3k, 0 otherwise, where f is the frequency expressed in Hz. The signal is modulates a carrier cos 16,000 pi t. And the resulting signal is passed through ideal band pass filter with unity gain and a central frequency 8k, bandwidth of 2k, the power in watts dash. So this is the signal power spectral density given, this is modulated and passed through filter, output we need to calculate. Simple logic, calculate the output PSD. Then you will get the, after getting the PSD, then you will get the power, because power is nothing but area under the PSD. First of all, if you see the, what is the power spectral density graph of the given input? If I say power spectral density graph is nothing but, here mod f is less than or equal to 3k means it lies between minus 3k to plus 3k. And if for negative values mod f is, for negative values mod f is minus f. So minus minus will become plus. Y equal mx plus c form. And positive values if you see there minus f will come because mod f is f, already negative is there. And if you are observing there, and what is the slope you have to calculate there? And what is the y-intercept they given? 10 power 6 multiplying with 3000. So I can say 3 into 10 power 3 zeros are gone. So minus 3. Are you getting my point? Simply substitute f value 0. What is its value at minus 2k? 1 into 10 power minus 3. At 2k, 2 into 10 power minus 3. 0, 3. At minus 1, 2 into 10 power minus 3. 0, 3 into 10 power minus 3. At 1, 2. 2, 1, like it's a slope of 1 into 10 power minus 3. This is modulated by some carrier. Then I am directly writing the power spectral intensity of that. And whenever if you multiply any signal with cos, its spectrum is shifted. But we are writing power spectral intensity. What is x of t into cos 2 pi f c t? 1 by 2 x of f minus f c plus f plus f c. But a power spectral intensity means modulus square. 1 by 2 square, 1 by 4. Shifting to f c as well as minus f c. What is the f c value given? 8k. So, write the same spectrum at 8k as well as minus 8k. And what is this amplitude you have to write? Divided by 4. So, 3 by 4 into 10 power minus 3. This value also same. And this value is 8k RR in kilohertz. This will be 11, this will be 5. Minus 5, minus 11. What is happening? This is passed through a band pass filter. Center frequency 8, bandwidth is 2. So, 8 bandwidth is 2 means this side up to 7, this side up to 9. This is the filter characteristics. Of course, same will be in the negative side. So, if I write the filter output student, from where to where it is passing? Passing from 7 to 9. And both are multiplied. If both are multiplied, how the thing will come? Here, from here to here. Both are equal ways you have right. What is the value here? We need to calculate first. From here to here, one unit less. So, obviously, one unit less. So, 2 by 4 into 10 power minus 3. Can you say what is its value at a 6? 1 by 4 into. So, if I write there, this is the spectrum output. So, this is the filter output. And what is this value? 2 by 4 into 10 power minus 3. What is this value? 3 by 4 into 10 power minus 3. Similar will also be in the negative side. See the filter. Red one and black one intersection will be the output. Red one and black one intersection will be the output. Now, what is the PSD area? If you see here, there is one rectangle is there as well as one triangle is there. So, this is given is in F domain. No need of writing 1 by 2 pi. What is the area of the rectangle? 2 into 10 cube. What is the height? 2 by 4 into 10 power minus 3. Plus, there is a triangle. What is a triangle? Half into width. Width is 2 into 10 cube. Because all are in kilohertz. What is the height? Height is nothing but this is already 2, this is 3. So, 1 by 4 into 10 power minus 3. This is only positive side. Same amount will be on the negative side. Whole is multiplied by 2. And if you observe here, 4, 2, 2 gone. 10 power 3, 10 power minus 3. So, 1 plus 2, 2 gone. Remaining is 10 power 3, 10 power minus 3. Are you getting my point or not? So, 10 power 3 and 10 power minus 3 will be gone. Remaining is 1 by 4. Means this is 1.25, but a whole is multiplied by 2 because same will also be there in the negative side. Then it will be 2.5 watts. Simple logic. Power spectral intensity passed through the modulated, passed through the filter. Because what is the x of t into cos Fourier transform you have to know? That is nothing but 1 by 2 into x of f minus fc plus x of f plus fc. But power spectral density means modulus square. 1 by 2 into modulus square. So that's why 1 by 2 square is 1 by 4. Shifting to fc minus fc. Clear? The power spectral density of a real stationary random process x of t is given by Sx of f equal to 1 by omega for mod f less than or equal to omega, 0 for mod f greater than 0. Just say before reading the point, here mod f greater less than or equal to omega means what is the meaning? Mod fl is f if f is positive, minus f if f is negative, then it will be f greater than or equal to omega. What is the meaning of this? The f value lies between, and here if you observe there, greater, yeah, and this, sorry, this minus will becomes this side, okay. And here what is the meaning of this? F value lies between minus omega to plus omega, because f greater than or minus omega less. What is the meaning of this? If f either greater than omega or less than minus omega, 0. Because mod f value is f for positive, minus f for negative. Then the value of some expectation is given. If you clearly observe there, pi constant right outside, expected value of x of t into t minus tau. What is that? Autocorrelation. So this is nothing but pi into rx of tau. Tau is 1 by 4 omega. Now, what is given? Power spectral density. What we need to calculate? Autocorrelation. What is the relation? Autocorrelation is nothing but inverse Fourier transform of power spectral density. Or power spectral density is nothing but Fourier transform of autocorrelation. So first calculate Rx of tau, inverse Fourier transform in F domain, no need of writing 1 by 2 pi. It is existed only from minus omega to plus omega. Its value is 1 by omega into e power j 2 pi f tau df. 1 by omega is a constant right outside. Integration of this will be same j 2 pi f tau divided by j 2 pi tau, because f is variable, minus omega to plus omega. So that is 1 by omega and pi and tau I written outside. Remaining you can observe. E power j theta lower limit minus e power minus j theta by 2j is nothing but sine theta. What is that theta value? 2 pi in place of f omega tau. And what is the tau value given here? 1 by 4 omega. Substitute tau value is 1 by 4 omega. Tau value is 1 by 4 omega. So omega omega gone. Here also omega omega gone, 2 1s 2 2, so pi by 2, sin pi by 2 is 1, divided by, here pi is there and 4 is there, 4 comes to the numerator, 4 into 1 4, divided by pi. But here we want pi into rx of 1 by omega. So here this value we got how much? 4 by pi into pi. So you have to type the answer 4. It is a simple question of analysis based. Don't get confusion. Here variable is f. And this is the meaning of the limits that you have to take care. Clear? The input to a 1 bit quantizer is a random variable x with PDF fx of x is 2 into e power minus 2x for x greater than or equal to 0. And fx of x is 0 for x less than 0. For outputs to be equal probability, quantizer threshold should be equal probability. Means probability of error for 0 and probability of error for 1 both are same. This problem can be done in two ways. Take the both and you can equate. Or you can also simply 1 by 2, 1 by 2 also you can take. Because total probability is 1. This manner can we do. So what's the probability for 0? Whenever input is greater than threshold. Greater means VTH to infinity f of x dx. When the probability of error for 1, whenever input is less than threshold, in the previous slide written, simply you can see probability of error for 0 is the probability of input, probability of error for 0. So greater than threshold. What is the probability of error for 1? Probability of input less than threshold. Because if it is less than threshold, it will treat as 0. but we transmitted 1. Greater means it is treated as 1, but you transmitted 0. Let us assume the threshold is VTH and f of x dx. What is the PDF is given? Integral VTH to infinity. What is the PDF? 2 into e power minus 2x dx. It is starting only from 0, 0 to VTH. F of x value, same. 2 into e power minus 2x dx. Regarding my point. For. 2 constant outside. E power minus 2x integration will be same. E power minus 2x by minus 2. Limits are threshold to infinity. This is 2 into e power minus 2x by minus 2. Limits are from 0 to VTH. Are you getting my point? Now, cancel the similar terms. Upper limit e power minus infinity 0. Lower limit. So, minus will be there. Minus minus will be plus. E power minus 2 VTH equal to. Here, if you substitute upper limit, you will have. But substitute lower and upper because negative you can cancel. Lower limit is 1 minus e power minus 2 VTH. Are you getting my point or not? Now, this you can send one side. So, this is nothing but 2 into e power minus 2 VTH value is 1. Or you can say e power minus 2 VTH value is nothing but 1 by 2. Apply anti-log on both sides. Minus 2 VTH equal to log 1 by 2 base E. Are you getting my point or not? So, if we calculate and you will get a VTH value something around 0.7. We can check this value. That 1 by 2 into log minus also there. Here negative will come. Negative, negative, positive. So, log of 1 by 2 E and divided by 2. You can get the value there. Clear? Consider a random process x of t root 2 sine 2 pi t plus phi, where the random phase phi is uniformly distributed in the interval 0 to 2 pi. The autocorrelation is already given directly. Formula also he given. Simply you have to substitute and you have to calculate. And he told that this is uniform random variable now. So how to write the property uniform PDF? Write its values are uniform in the given limits. And what about this value? 1 by 2 pi. Got my point or not? And substitute here. That is expected value of x of t. X of t 1. So root 2 into sine 2 pi t 1 plus phi. Into root 2 sine 2 pi t 2 plus phi. Then this is nothing but expected value of root 2 into 2. So, here, if you observe root 2 into root 2 is 2, sin A into sin B formula. What is sin A sin B formula? Cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. Because negative is not given, first A minus B, next A plus B, but a cos you have to write. So, 2 already there. So, cos A minus B, that is 2 pi T1 minus T2. 5 cancel. I can also write separately expected value of cos A plus B. That is 2 pi T1 plus T2 plus 5 2 phi. Here no phi, it is a constant. So write outside. So cos 2 pi of T1 minus T2. And if you observe there, nothing is there. So 1, expected value of 1 is 1. And the second integral is 0. So, this is the answer. Why is our second integral is 0? You can feel whole is nothing but some x. Expected value of x means average value or DC value or mean value over the period of 2 pi. 2 pi is time period. If you calculate the area of the cos or sine over one period is 0 because total area is 0, positive is equal to negative. So, if you see there, which option? I can say option D, cos 2 pi into T1 minus T2. Clear? Common models. Calculation of autocorrelation. Directly he already given just substitute, but this you have to know. This is a constant outside, this is a variable, so mean value 0. let x be a real value random variable with e of x and e of x square denoting the mean values of x and x square. So xn means mean, x square means mean square value. Respectively, the relation which holds good. We already knows that, of course, mean is nothing but students expected value of x, and a mean square is nothing but expected value of x square. And we have another parameter variance, which is m2 minus m1 square. That is expected value of x square minus expected value of x square, na? So square it. We already knows that variance can never be negative. So always this is greater than or equal to 0. Then obviously e of x square is greater than or equal to e of x whole square. E of x square greater than or equal to e of x whole square. So option B, very simple question. Logic is variance cannot be negative. Let x1, x2, x3 be independent and identically distributed random variables with the uniform distribution on 0 to 1. The probability P, x1 is largest. Maybe he will give you x1 largest, x2 smallest, x3 like that. They might be given different questions. Here they are given multiple random variables uniformly distributed. Then all will having equal chances of either highest or lowest, because he told uniformly distributed in the same region. So the probability of x1 largest or x2 or x3 will have equal chances, or smallest also equal chances. 3 are there, then what is the probability of that? Obviously 1 by 3. If 4 is given, 1 by 4. Maybe highest or smallest, everything will be same if they are giving uniform distribution equal region. Clear? Let x of t be a WSS random process with the PSD SX of f. If y of t is processed as y of t equal x of 2t minus 1, PSD SY of f is PSD of y of t. Very simple problem. How to calculate the PSD? First apply Fourier transform. Are you getting my point? Then you will get y of f. Apply the Fourier transform. That is y of f equal to x of, here, x of 2t minus 1. For our easy of understanding, can I bring as, first if you take for x of t is Fourier transform. One second. For x of t, Fourier transform is, you can feel as some x of f. Then I am taking x of t minus 1. What is the Fourier transform? Same x of f, e power minus j 2 pi f t naught. And we are doing the time scaling. So 2t minus 1 will have 1 by 2 into x of, replace f by 2, e power minus j pi f, because replace f with f by 2. This is, for this one, this is a Fourier transform. This is nothing but y of t, and this is nothing but y of f. After getting the Fourier transform, take the modulus. What is the modulus of this? 1 by 2 into x of f by 2. Because modulus of this is 1. Are you getting my point or not? Now, you can square, because modulus square is nothing but what? Modulus square is nothing but what? The PSD. If you square, then what you will get? 1 by 2 into this modulus square. Now, what is this? Is nothing but, he told SX of F, because PSD of X, but in place of F, F by 2 is there. So, you can go with the options. Construct two identically zero mean random variables U and V. Let cumulative distribution functions of U and 2V be F of X and G of X respectively. Then for all values of X, he given some four options. In all options, he is asking the difference between F of X minus G of X, whether it is a positive or a negative. It is greater than or equal to 0 or less than or equal to 0. In last two options, you also multiplied with x. And if you observe there, what is f of x? f of x is nothing but cdf of u. So probability of u less than or equal to x. What is g of x? G of x is the cdf of 2v. So this is and u and v are identical. So I replaced with another random variable x. Obviously these two will come this side, x byte. Are you getting my point or not? Because u and v are identical, to send this side. And if you see the all options, we already knows that the CDF function is never decreasing function. Always it is a increases function. Never decreasing means, for example, if I take any one graph of the CDF, for example, I have a CDF function like this. Values minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, here 0.2, here 0.3. And here it is 0.5. Let's take this value is some 1 because total probability is 1. Like some PDF, because it's never a decreasing function. Why I taken for negative and positive? Because all values he told. Now if you observe, simple, when compared with x, x by 2 is smaller. So if you are going to the positive side, then this value will be larger. For your more clarity, I can take first situation, x is positive. For example, from this graph, if I take x value 2, what is f of x, p of x less than or equal to 2? How much? 1. Minus. What is g of x? 2 by 2, 1. X less than or equal to 1. How much? 0.5. 1 minus 0.5 is positive or negative? Positive. Suppose if I take x value some 10, then p of x less than or equal to 10 is obviously from here onwards. Sorry, that I written wrong. So like it's continuous, sorry. Because it's never decreasing from continuous. So 10 if I take 1, this is 10 by 2. 5, this is also 1. 1 minus 1 means you can say 0. So for greater than or equal to f of x minus g of x value greater than or equal to 0. Negative values, let's see. Suppose x value is less than 0. Let's take x equal to, for example, minus 2. What is f of x? This is less than or equal to minus 2. Less than or equal to minus 2, what is the value? 0.2. What is g of x? Minus 2 by 2, minus 1. Coming this value as 0.3. So this is negative. Some more values if I take, still lesser values I can share you, I can show you both are difference is equal to 0. Means if you observe, for a positive values greater than or equal to 0, negative values less than or equal to 0, you got. Simple by taking the graph analyzation. Now if you see the option, first option is saying less than, second option greater than. But here, sometimes greater than, sometimes less than, so not. If you see the third option, f of x minus g of x into x. Here this difference is positive, x is positive, multiplication is positive, greater than or equal to 0. Here x is negative, difference is negative, product will be positive. So, I can say, here it told less than, but here it told greater than. So, always the multiplication of x with f of x minus g of x is positive. Clear? In a power spectral density of a real process x of t for a positive frequencies is shown below. The value of e of x square and e of x of t respectively are. This is a PDF graph given. And if you see the solution there, simple first. What is called e of x square? What is called e of x of t? What is e of x square? Mean square value called power. What is e of x of t? Mean value. First I will calculate mean value. What is the mean value means? DC value. DC value means what is the frequency? 0. If you see the spectrum, anything is given at zero, no spectrum is there. So, mean value zero. One thing is done. Second, E of x square means mean square value. Mean square value is nothing but what? Power. How to calculate power from power spectral density? 1 divided by 2 pi into area under PSD. Calculate the area of that. 1 by 2 pi into, what is the area of the triangle? Half into its width. Width is 2 into 10 cube into height. Are you getting? Half into width into height. And this is the area of the triangle. And another impulse also there. What is the area of the impulse? It's a multiplication only, its area. And he clearly told for positive frequencies. So, same also there for negative, so into 2. If you are not taking 2, options does not match. Then 2 cancelled, here 2 cancelled, and this is 10 cube, sorry, into 10 cube, yeah. 6000 plus 400, 6400 divided by pi. If you are not taking 3200, none of the option given. And he clearly mentioned for a positive, so negative also there, so I multiplied with 2. Simple. Power is nothing but area under the PSD. If F domain given, no need of writing 1 by 2 pi. Clear? Two independent random variables, X and Y, uniformly distributed in the interval minus 1 to 1. The probability that max X, Y is less than 1 by 2, is less than 1 by 2 is. If you see the question here itself, he told that both are independent random variables, uniformly distributed. So, what is the PDF of X? PDF of X, and I am writing the PDF of Y. If you see the PDF of X, students, uniformly distributed from minus 1 to 1. This also minus 1 to 1. So, uniform distribution means its values are uniform. What is this value? 1 by upper minus lower limit, 1 by upper minus lower limit. Or, we already know, total area under the PDF is 1. That concept also you can apply. Now, see there. And what is asking? Probability of that max. So, probability of max of X, Y less than 1 by 2. And he told both are independent now. So, I can write simply probability of X less than 2 or less than or equal, no problem. Because with the points, it doesn't make any sense. So, here I written one time equal to another time. Just like less than I given. Less than, sorry, 1 by 2. How I can write, one second. How I can write this like independently? Why I can write separately? Because the given random variables are independent random variables. How to calculate a probability? Integral minus infinite to 1 by 2. But functions are starting only from minus 1. So, minus 1 to 1 by 2 is a PDF f of x dx into integral minus 1 to 1 by 2 f of y into dy. What is the f of x value? 1 by 2 constant outside. Integral dx value x. Limits are from 1 by 2 minus of minus 1 plus 1. For this one also 1 by 2 constant outside. And integral dy is y. Y is 1 by 2 minus of minus plus 1. This is 3, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into. This is nothing but how much? 1 plus 1 by 3 by 2. This is also 3 by 2. So, 3 by 4. Sorry, 3 into 3 by 4. This is 1. This is 3 by 2. This is also 3 by 2. 3 into 3, 2 2s are 4. Are you getting my point? Then, it is nothing but 9 divided by 4 4s are 16. So, 9 by 16. You can see option B. Clear?